Hello, and welcome to the Legacy Education ICD-10-CM Guideline Review Series. I am Tiffany Roach, the coding coach, and I will be walking you through ICD-10-CM guidelines with you. This video will cover the chapter-specific guidelines for Chapter 2 for neoplasms, represented by codes C00 through D49. This presentation is designed to review the ICD-10-CM guidelines that are effective for both fiscal year 2024 and 2025. There were no significant changes to the guidelines from fiscal year 2024 to 2025. Before covering the specific sections within the neoplasm chapter, there are some important topics to become familiar with. While Chapter 2 of the ICD-10-CM contains codes for most benign and malignant neoplasms, there are certain benign neoplasms that can be found in other chapters corresponding with the body systems. In order to code for a neoplasm, it is first important to determine the behavior of the neoplasm, such as malignant, carcinoma in situ, benign, or uncertain behavior. When the malignancy is indicated, it is necessary to determine whether it is primary or secondary. When a malignancy is primary and it overlaps two or more neighboring sites, subcategory 0.8 should be used to indicate overlapping lesions are present. If multiple neoplasms are present at the same site and do not have overlapping borders, such as tumors in different quadrants of the breasts, a code for each site should be assigned. If the malignant neoplasms of ectopic tissue are present, then they should be coded to the site of the origin that is mentioned. Lastly, we'll go over how to properly find a neoplasm. The table of neoplasms should be referenced first, unless a histological term is documented, in which case that term should be referenced prior to checking the table of neoplasms. In the index, your main term will have an instructional note that will indicate what behavior you should use in the neoplasm table. The table itself provides columns to properly code based on the behavior. The first column is arranged by anatomic locations. The next three columns represent malignant neoplasms. A primary neoplasm represents where the malignancy has originated. Secondary neoplasm represents where the malignancy has spread to from its primary site. And then your carcinoma in situ represents a malignancy that is encapsulated by a site. Benign lesions are when there are no malignant cells present within a lesion. Uncertain behavior should only be used when there is a pathology report that indicates that they are unable to determine the behavior. Unspecified behavior is when there has not been confirmation of whether the neoplasm is either malignant or benign, and you will use this column when there is no specification or pathology report available. When a patient presents with a malignancy and it is responsible for the admission or encounter, and the treatment is directed at the primary site, the primary malignancy should be listed first. The exception is when the patient is being seen for the sole purpose of administering chemotherapy, immunotherapy, or radiation therapy. When the encounter is solely to administer that chemo, immuno, or radiation therapy, a code from category Z51 should be listed first, followed by the underlying diagnosis or condition that's responsible for the visit. When a primary and secondary neoplasm exist and the treatment is directly towards the metastatic site, the secondary neoplasm should be sequenced first, followed by the primary malignancy if it is still present. When the encounter is for management of anemia that is associated with a malignancy and the treatment is only directed at the anemia, the malignancy code is sequenced first, followed by the appropriate code for the anemia. When the encounter is for the management of the anemia that is associated with an adverse effect of the administration of the chemo or immunotherapy, and the treatment is for the anemia itself, you should sequence the anemia first, followed by the adverse effect for the chemo or immunotherapy, which is represented by subcategory T45.1X5. When the encounter is for the management of the anemia that is associated with the adverse effect of the administration of radiotherapy, the anemia code should be sequenced first, followed by Y84.2 for the adverse effect of the radiation. When the patient is seen for dehydration due to the malignancy and only the dehydration is being addressed with IV rehydration, the dehydration should be sequenced first, followed by the code for the malignancy. If the encounter is for treatment of a complication that has resulted from a surgical procedure, the complication should be listed first if the treatment is directed at resolving the complication of the surgical procedure. When a malignancy has been removed from its site and there is no further treatment directed at the site of the malignancy, as well as no further evidence of the malignancy, it will be coded as a personal history of the malignant neoplasm. In easier terms, if a breast malignancy has been excised but continues chemo, immuno, or radiotherapy, it will still be coded as a current neoplasm. Once treatment has been completed, it can be coded as a personal history of the neoplasm. If there is any mention that the malignancy has spread to another site, it will be coded as a secondary malignancy to the new site. If a secondary malignancy is present, it will be listed first, then followed by the history code from category Z85, listed second. When the encounter is for the surgical removal of a neoplasm, followed by chemo or radiation therapy within the same encounter, the code for the neoplasm should be assigned first. If the encounter is strictly for the administration of chemo, immuno, or radiation therapy, your treatment should be listed first, followed by the malignancy where the therapy is directed. For radiation therapy, code Z51.0 should be used. For chemotherapy, code Z51.11 should be assigned. And for immunotherapy, code Z51.12 should be assigned. If more than one type of therapy is administered during an admission or encounter, you will use as many of the codes necessary to accurately represent the treatments. If the encounter is for insertion of radioactive elements, such as your brachytherapy, the malignancy should be listed first. Z51.0 should not be coded, as your brachytherapy is not an external beam radiotherapy. If the patient is admitted for chemo, immuno, or radiation therapy, and they develop complications such as controlled nausea or vomiting, you should assign a code for the therapy, such as Z51.0, Z51.11, or Z51.12, followed by codes for any complication. If the patient is admitted solely for the insertion or implantation of radioactive elements, such as brachytherapy, and they develop complications, the first listed diagnosis should be the malignancy, followed by any complications. Code Z51.0 should not be assigned, as your brachytherapy is not an external beam radiation therapy. When the reason for the encounter is to determine the extent of the malignancy, the primary malignancy or the appropriate metastatic site should be assigned as the first listed diagnosis, even if chemo or radiation therapy is administered. If signs or symptoms are reported with an existing primary or secondary diagnosis, they should never be reported as a first listed diagnosis, regardless of the number of admissions or encounters for treatment and the care of the neoplasm. If your encounter is for pain control or pain management associated with a neoplasm, you will see the guidelines for Chapter 6 on how to report it. Sometimes a patient can have more than one malignancy within the same organ. Depending on the site, they can represent different primary or metastatic tumors. If the documentation is unclear as to the status of each tumor, you should query your provider for clarification so that the correct codes can be assigned. When the patient has advanced metastatic disease and there is no known primary or secondary site specified, code C80.0 should be assigned. This should not be used in place of any codes for all known primary or secondary sites. Code C80.1 should only be used when there is no determination that can be made for the primary site of the malignancy, and it should rarely be used. Sequencing of neoplasms can be a little tricky, so here's a few examples. If the reason for the encounter is for the treatment of the primary malignancy, it should be listed first, followed by any codes for metastatic sites. When an encounter is for a primary malignancy with metastasis, and the only treatment is for the secondary site, then the metastatic site should be listed first, followed by the code for the primary malignancy. If a patient is pregnant and has a malignant neoplasm, the first listed code should be from subcategory 09A.1, followed by the appropriate code for the neoplasm. When the encounter is for the management of a complication associated with a neoplasm, the complication should be sequenced first, followed by the code for the neoplasm with one exception, and that exception is for anemia. If the treatment is only for the anemia, the malignancy should be sequenced first, followed by code D63.0 for your anemia and neoplastic disease. When the encounter is for treatment of a complication that has resulted from a surgical procedure and that was performed for the treatment of the neoplasm, the complication should be listed first. The neoplasm code should be based on the guideline for current versus history of your neoplasm. If the encounter is for a pathological fracture due to the neoplasm and the treatment is directed towards the fracture, a code from subcategory M84.5 should be sequenced first, followed by a code for the neoplasm. If the treatment is directed at the neoplasm and not the fracture, the neoplasm should be sequenced first, followed by the code for the pathological fracture from M84.5. When a primary malignancy has been excised or removed and there is further treatment directed towards the location of the malignancy, the current primary malignancy should be coded until treatment has been completed. When the primary malignancy has been removed and there's no further treatment directed to the site, as well as no evidence of any existing malignancy at the site, it can be coded as a personal history and a code from category Z85 should be used. Codes Z85.0 through Z85.85 should be assigned only for histories of primary malignancies. Z85.89 is appropriate for a history of either a primary or secondary malignancy. When coding for leukemia, category C90 has codes indicating whether the leukemia has achieved remission or not. For a personal history of leukemia or lymphoid tissue, you will use code Z85.6 or Z85.79. If there's any confusion on whether the leukemia has achieved remission, you should query your provider for clarification. For aftercare, follow-up care, or prophylactic organ removal for malignancies, you should see Chapter 21 guidelines for your instructions. If a malignant neoplasm is present on a transplanted organ, it should be coded as a complication of the transplant. A total of 3 codes should be used in these instances. First, a code from category T86 should be listed, followed by C80.2, and then a code for the specific malignancy that is present. When a breast implant is associated with anaplastic large cell lymphoma, also referred to as BIA, ACLCL, you should assign either C84.7A or C84.7B based on whether remission has been achieved. A code from Chapter 19 for complications should not be assigned. When a malignant neoplasm of lymphoid tissue spreads beyond the lymph nodes, a code from category C81 through C85 should be assigned instead of a code for the secondary neoplasm. For example, if diffuse large B-cell lymphoma spreads to the lung, brain, or left adrenal gland, code C83.398 should be assigned. As always, thank you for supporting us and make sure to stay tuned for new videos in our ICD-10-CM guideline review. Make sure to subscribe to our channel so that you can be in the know of our newest videos that are released.